Glomerulonephritis is the inflammation of the parts of the kidneys that is responsible for the filtration of the blood. It can be caused by a number of medical conditions that result in damage, and therefore the inability of the body to get rid of waste products and body fluid. Sometimes the damage is so bad that it stops working completely, and then it's termed renal failure. The disease presents in acute and chronic manners. In the acute form, the onset is sudden, but in the chronic form, symptoms develop slowly over many years and usually produce no symptoms until there is severe disease and sometimes irreversible damage to your kidneys. The condition can occur in adults, but is most common in children. What are the causes of glomerulonephritis? Glomerulonephritis can start after something relatively benign like a sore throat or even a skin infection, but other illness can cause this condition. This includes systemic lupus erythematosus, Henoch-Schönlein purpura, amyloidosis, vasculitis, heavy use of non-steroidal anti-inflammatories or NSAIDs like ibuprofen and naproxen, Wegener's granulomatosis, polyarteritis nodosa, and a certain degrees of immune system changes. Many times doctors are unable to figure out what exactly caused it. We just know that you have it. What are the symptoms? The mild form of glomerulonephritis usually has no symptoms. More severe disease can be present itself with discolored urine, often pink or grossly bloody or tea-colored. Foamy urine due to the excess of protein in it. Symptoms that are like drowsiness, nausea, vomiting, headaches, appetite loss, decreased urination, and sometimes even fever. The patient can wake up with a swollen face, eyelids, hands, and ankles. Other symptoms include shortness of breath, cough, high blood pressure, blistery, dry, or itchy skin. Nighttime cramps are also very common. Symptoms can last for a few weeks or even several months. Diagnosis. The doctors make the diagnosis from the medical history and urine tests that show protein and blood cells. Also, blood tests and ultrasounds of the kidneys are done. Sometimes a biopsy is required to make the definitive diagnosis and to better decide the correct treatment protocol for your particular kind of glomerulonephritis. What is the treatment? In children, the recovery is much quicker, but a nephrologist will need to be involved to coordinate the treatment and follow-up that will be needed for that child. Sometimes glomerulonephritis goes away by itself. However, sometimes medications that affect the immune system like steroids have been used. A special procedure called plasmapheresis is sometimes necessary. In this procedure, the blood is filtered artificially to remove antibodies in it and is replaced with intravenous fluids or donated plasma. Hemodialysis can be done temporarily to help remove the excess fluid and poisons that build up off the body as a result of these non-working kidneys. There is no specific treatment for the chronic form of this disease. Following a special diet that is low in protein, salt, and potassium is essential. Blood pressure pills and calcium supplements may need to be prescribed. It is important that these blood pressure pills be taken exactly as prescribed, since high blood pressure control is the most important thing you can do to control or even slow down the kidney damage or injury. If you suffer from this condition and start feeling better, don't stop taking the medications unless your doctor specifically instructs you to do so. Complications: fluid overload like pulmonary edema or congestive heart failure, chronic kidney disease, high blood pressure, and even malignant hypertension, hyperkalemia and many other electrolyte abnormalities, nephrotic syndrome, and even end-stage kidney disease needing hemodialysis. You must call your doctor if you have increasing or more severe symptoms. Since this condition can affect many other systems, the symptoms are variable, so your doctor needs to check it out.